gonna start, listen up. We're gonna start the sandbag sprint, heats of five. So instead of lining you guys up as singles, we're gonna line you up in groups of five. Questions?
Yeah, I'm just trying to stick with the game plan. Stay in the middle of the pack and stay out of that bottom 10 position and hopefully do pretty well in these next three events. Sprint up this hill. Yeah, absolutely. There's no holding back. It's 170 meters. I mean, how can you?
First two out of the way.
Yes. Now it starts.
Next event, is this an all-out sprint or is there pacing?
No. Guns blazing. I'm going to watch some people, but I think I'm going to go two on one shoulder, grab it, keep some balance.
What's your plan of attack at this event?
Go, baby.
Bags, or is it grab the bags and all out sprint?
All out sprint. I'm gonna watch first though. I'll watch these guys engage what's going on out there. And then I'll watch my man Lance and see what happens. And then I'll, more like this is just go. This is balls to the wall, make it happen. This event is totally different though because we just did a five miler and a deadlift heavy dead. So like, it's a whole nother ball game. Anybody that expects it to be something or not, or oh, this is my thing, I'm a sprint, is gonna pull up with a hammy and hop up the hill. So it's like, you don't know. That's the greatest thing. What's the theme of this thing? Knowing the unknowable, whatever. So you don't know what's gonna happen. So nutrition, it's a sport of nutrition too. So if these people aren't rehydrating, if I'm not rehydrating and getting the right nutrients, then I mean, you don't know what's gonna happen.
It just occurred to me, we're only two-thirds of the way done, so I was pumped up. That took a little wind out of my sails. Yeah, I made it through all the deadlifts, which I had to do to stay in the game, so happy about that. You know, more hoping for that top five, something like that now. So I think the winner's going to be under 70 points, and I already have 32 points after two events, so five more to go. I need to be in the top, which I know the sledgehammer and the last workout today gonna be hard for me, so hoping to make the cut for tomorrow.
What makes you think the sledgehammer is gonna be hard for you?
I have very poor hand-eye coordination and I'm very bad at things. I'm not a natural athlete. I have to practice things over and over and over again to get them. And obviously this was not a regular CrossFit event, so don't have a lot of practice, so I'm gonna struggle.
How are you doing this next sandbag here?
It's gonna be hard. If we did this one first, it would be a sprint. Coming up third, we've already ran too many hills, and you know, the posterior chain is gone from the deadlift, which is what you primarily use to get up a hill. Sandbags on your back, it's only 70 pounds, it's gonna feel really heavy after the deadlift workout, so, man, I'm not looking forward to it, not at all, not one bit.
Do you have a strategy?
I think I'm gonna go one on each shoulder. I'm gonna pick the bags up in the middle, and hopefully that separates the sand evenly, and then just throw them over.
At the same time?
Yeah. So, you know, because if you lift it up on one side, all the sand's going to fall. So, that's what I'm going to try. We'll see. I've never done it.
And it looks pretty short, 170 meters. Do you expect to just go all through the wall the whole way?
Yes. Yeah. I have to. I'm trying to be competitive here.
Yay! Here we go. Sandbag sprint.
Yeah. The men are going to have two 35-pound sandbags. The sandbags are not full, so there's a lot of room for that sand to move around. Sandbags are going to be lying on the ground, and the athlete's going to have to pick up the bags and sprint up the hill. It's about 170 meters, pretty much straight up the hill.
3, 2, 1, go!
The green light flashes and the fire goes up.
Here they go. Up.
Let's go, man. legs are cramped.
Ah, keep going.
It's open. The radio down says one guy didn't have the number on his left arm. They gotta get numbers on the
left arm. I cramped on the run, the first one halfway through. I was cramping on the digs. I don't know what the fuck's going on. Like,
have you ever cramped up before?
No. I've been hydrating. I don't know what the fuck to do.
113 and 143.
Fuck. My legs just locked up. Cramping.
Spotters go halfway down.
And they're still cramping. I just can't move.
Got 143.
Where at? In your quad?
Hamstring.
I need a 143.
Fuck. Can't get up.
Yeah, I know that. 10 seconds. Three, two, one, go. Here we go.
Last mark.
Ten sandbags. Check for your station.
Pat Bullen, that's the ground. Get some sandbag issues.
I'm shot. Everything's shot. I'm investing in a bulldozer.
Right there.
And I'm plowing this bitch down.
And double arm was not the way to roll.
Oh, Savannah, that was horrible.
My hamstrings.
My ass on fire. My ass is done.
I'm just surviving right now, Savannah.
All right, Dan.
Just survive.
Jeff T, where's... God damn, dude.
You know.
Off to the races, man.
So, Dan, we've got 2-2-3.
You know what that simulator was? Stair climbs. I don't know.
Give another.
I didn't hear.
Give another.
Simulator me getting my fucking wallet stolen.
10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go! False start, we're gonna restart this heat. Put your sandbags back down, we had a false start. Restarting this heat.
That's the point of this games, I think. I think the it's spread out so widely over different domains, long domain, really short and heavy. There's got that high coordination piece with the sledgehammer. We got the sandbag run. The last three events actually seem kind of strength-based. We'll have to see how heavy that snatch is, but it seems like a strength-based thing. Kind of bummed about that, but it doesn't really matter.
3, 2, 1, go.
That was fun. I'm so stoked. Holy shit.
Two more.
Having people yell at you?
Head timers.
Is awesome.
Head timers. Head timer.
That was hands down the hardest ride I've ever done in my life. That 7K was hard. Very different type of hard. I couldn't move. The legs. I almost fell over.
Okay, the third event is a sandbag sprint. Folks are going to start right here in front of the stands, front and center. The men are going to have two 35-pound loosely packed sandbags. There's going to be plenty of room for the sand to move around. And they're going to be lying down on the ground. The athlete, 3, 2, 1, go.
2, 1, go.
Picks up both sandbags and sprints. And there's a run. It's a straight run, pretty much. And it's about 170 meters. And it's pretty much straight up. The hill gets steeper as you go along. So you're going to see athletes moving. And then you're going to see them slow down. It's tough. It ended up, in our preliminary test, it ended up feeling and timing a lot like a 400 meter sprint.
107. 107. Great
fucking
job.
That fucking hill. Fuck that. Shit.
That was fast, dude. The last one was the fastest.
123 was the fastest. Barber, what Barber get? Okay. Tell you what, my legs are fried. Legs are fried.
What was harder, that first run or this run?
First run sucked. That was by far the hardest effing thing anybody's that I've done ever. Well, close to. I'm just going for every workout that I possibly can. Give it all I got at that time, at that moment. Try and enjoy myself. Yeah, I don't know. Doing it for 2 years, just want to hang out and try it out, see what happens. So if I get gain time, if I gain, good. If I don't, well. Pastorek.
I love to compete, and nothing makes me more happy than winning. So yeah, anything I'm gonna do, whether it's rolling a rock up a hill or whatever, I'm gonna try to win. Yeah, I'm always ready to push myself like I've never pushed myself. So. This kind of atmosphere just brings the best out of people, I think. And I'm excited to just give it a shot, see where I end up. Somebody who's, you know, trying to make themselves just the best they can be. That's really all we're here for, just to better ourselves, make life good.
So if I can get in my watt, I throw every little bit of intensity that I have towards it. I apply as much power, as much intensity as I can every single day. And try to hit the 3 day on, 1 day off thing. You know, if that makes me special, whatever. I just doing what everybody else does.
Last week, training through some of the wads, man, we were trying to do some long stuff with 800s mixed in with, you know, overhead squats, chest to bar pull-ups, things like that. And, you know, you hit that suck factor halfway through and you're just like, God, I want to quit. And the games is what actually keeps you pushing through that. The mental part of it, I really, if I wasn't training for something in particular, it'd be a lot easier to slow down or say, you know, screw it, and just kind of weasel your way through the rest of the workout. But mental part, I mean, I think a lot of people don't realize how much mental toughness goes into this stuff. Because it really is, you know, anybody can physically lift up this amount of weight, anybody can run that distance, but can you do it in this amount of time and suffer through the pain while doing it? And I feel like I'm where I need to be right now. You know, it's Tony and I were just talking at dinner tonight. We're like, what happens if you get halfway through that run and you're just saying to yourself, why the hell am I doing this? Why am I doing this again? Because last year we kept saying to ourselves when we were done on Sunday, we were like, dude, we're never doing that again. That was the worst feeling ever. But the feeling when you are done is absolutely great.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
legs just locked up. I felt like I couldn't go. Good job. It's hard. It's bitch.
How was it?
It's all legs.
Fucking burns the legs.
Yeah.
Big time. That last 20 meters or so right there just attacks the quads, hammies.
Yeah, it just didn't have anything. It was like, come on, blood flow.
This hamstring looks like it's doubled in size.
It's good.
You still have a smile on your face.
It's a good workout, man. That's what we're here for, good workouts.
Have you ever done anything like this?
Never. Nope. That's good. It's a first and it's fucking badass.
The technique that you use to grab the sandbag, and the guys especially, do you grab one, do you grab the other, do you grab them together, do you throw them over one shoulder, one over each, do you try to grip them, what's the technique, do you pick them up with your hands, run with them, then throw them over your shoulders when you have a little momentum going? This is all to be played out. The athletes will have some time to play with the sandbags before they're thrown into the event, and we'll see what happens. This is a short event. This is a sprint. It's all out power.
Chris Spiller from CrossFit Park City. And the 2008 CrossFit Games champion, Jason Khalifa.
I love CrossFit. I love the community. I love how it changes people's lives. But I have to remind myself that my performance doesn't define me as who I am. And I think when we start to step outside of that box and start to think about what really truly matters to us, that takes a lot of pressure off. You know, that takes a lot of pressure off of me and anyone else, that winning does not define who you are. And I think honestly that, you know, aside from a ton of hard work and kind of refusing to believe that you can't do something, that right there is kind of it. Just refusing to say no, but also knowing that a victory doesn't define who you are.
The male and female participant in the 2009 games that finished number one, in my opinion, and again, it's my opinion, but I believe that they will be the fittest male and fittest female on the planet. Apart from everybody just being here and competing at it, you know, they're great athletes, but the winner, just like last year, absolutely. Because you got such a broad, you know, spectrum of exercises and modalities, I think. Absolutely, we can say that. Hell yeah, we can say that.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Is he gonna split the difference? Is he gonna split the middle? Chris Spiller takes the lead. There he goes, 100 pounds. Chris Spiller's trucking. Chris Spiller's taking the lead. Let's see if he can cross the finish line in first place. So, Chris, Jason, Chris Ryan, Jason Khalifa, number two. What a heat.
Good job, boys.
Good job, Bill.
Is that it?
Yeah,
good.
That's fun. Good job, brother. Good job.
Dude, that fucking hit me like a fucking truck.
fucking bend my knees.
Do you know what our times were? Fuck.
Thanks. Holy shit.
Yeah, baby.
Dude.
Wow.
Oh, my butt. It's on fire. It's killing.
Do you want to rub?
It's like the fan in your forearms, but in your butt.
Three, two, one, go! Sorry, we got an early lead. Bravo, Leonard takes the lead.
Get it up. Get it up on your shoulder.
Come on! 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 Come on!
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
How was that? You didn't slow down.
That was the idea.
You guys were crashing about 20 feet away from the train. Do you want to quit?
Yes. Yes. Oh. That was good. Oh, I'm so glad that's over. Oh, it's fun. In a sick kind of way.
Yeah, so in a short event like this, we have 60 athletes. The differences between first and last might be very small. We suspect that the best times for this will be about a minute, maybe a little bit less. In such a short event, every second is going to count again. And what technique you use to grab the sandbag could make a big impact. Your ability to recover a sandbag starting to fall on the fly. This is agility, this is skill, there's some coordination. It's real world. I like it. I think it tests components of fitness that are intelligent.
During workouts, during hard workouts, during rigorous workouts, you know, you're only human to have those feelings of doubt where your mind wants to tell you, you know, quit, or this is too hard for you, or, you know, you're not gonna win, so, you know, why keep going hard? To me, I think one of the biggest things that I always tell myself is that all these workouts are gonna be hard and they're gonna be painful, and that's not gonna ever subside. So if you can just get yourself to kind of accept that fact that it's hard, it's no matter what, that from the beginning to the end, that you just kind of put that on the back burner and you just kind of keep going. Plus, I always felt myself as, and people as the mind being stronger, you know, and the body will just keep working. It'll just keep working. So if you tell it, until it breaks down, you just keep working. Just keep working.
Three, two, one, go!
Can you see if you're watching the video, but it's straight down the middle.
Area number
Like I've said before, this is like the pinnacle, it's the cherry on top, yeah? It's that ability, it's like my whole life building up to this point, the physical and the mental capacities. We have the Australasian qualifiers, and I took myself to a new level of self-inflicted physical and psychological pain. Like I passed out after one of the workouts. I don't think I've ever felt as much pain in my legs as I did after the Australasian qualifiers. I was happy to just go into the workouts and finish in the top three, the top five. But after coming in first in the first workout, and I drew in the second workout, it was like, I've got to take out the third workout, you know? And to be able to do that and come out on top and win the qualifier there and have the opportunity to come here, it's a dream come true.
Pretty tough. Tougher than last year's run.
Of course I'm nervous, and of course I put pressure on myself and I got pressure from everywhere, so no. I'm hoping to do good, but you know, you can't do good if you don't have any pressure on you. You know, you have to have some pressure and put pressure on yourself. So that's a part of it.
4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Nice move, takes the lead. And Sven, lead.
I'm excited. I'm, you know, ecstatic. It's just great. Yeah.
I thought that deadlift competition was gonna knock you out.
Yeah.
Pretty happy.
Yeah, I was really happy with that. I wanted to get that last year. I got 4:45 to the middle of my thighs. Just needed a couple of centimeters more, but I was happy with it. It was my personal best, so. It's good.
The Americans are having a good time with the pronunciation of your name.
Yeah, They're always making fun of it, so it's a difficult name. So that's just fun. Get, you know, get your little attention.
Yeah, they can't say your name, but they can't forget you either.
Yeah, exactly. They're nobody. They're nobody's from Iceland.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Do you want to stop? That's what your brain's telling you.
Are you hearing the crowd here for you?
Oh man, it's the only way I'm doing this right now.
2007, I finished third. 2008, I finished second. Am I a better athlete now? I think I'm right there. I think 08, I was more prepared than 07. I'm feeling about the same as last year, as fit as I've ever been in my life. There's no preparation issues. If I don't win or if I don't compete well, it's because I had a bad weekend or the competition was just better than me. It's not because I'm not prepared. So I'm ready to go.
In the Army, I'm a captain in the infantry. I'm with the 82nd Airborne right now. I didn't know whether or not I was going to be able to come if I qualified or not. We were kind of working both things at once. My commander was trying to get the approval, so to speak, for me to be able to come here at the same time as we were working through the event itself. But Colonel McGuire, the brigade commander, is absolutely outstanding and is all about soldiers doing things for the Army and to make themselves better. And so this was right in line with what he would wanted us to do.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Thank you.
That was miserable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't as hard as I thought it would be.
I mean, it was fucking hard.
I just felt like
it was hard.
Went all right.
But you're good.
I mean, it's just your legs. You know, your legs stop working.
You guys feel certain?
Yeah, I do. Especially after those first two. Honestly. Just good to still be in it.
And in first place, JC Nessa. Out of Yerba Linda, California.
And I think Josh Everett says it the best is there's about 6 workouts a year that you can put everything into it. His track coach told him 6 to 8 workouts. Hell, how many are we doing this weekend? 7? So I heard that said and I was like, yeah, I got 7 workouts, maybe a year. I can put everything, every ounce of my being into. And these got to be my 7 because I don't know if I'm going to be alive tomorrow or Monday, but this is everything. And so every workout that I do, I don't go to my max potential. I come to the edge of it and basically look over the cliff and don't punch it through the end, because if I do, I won't be able to come to the games top notch.
4, 3, 2, 1, go! All start, reset.
Come on, guys.
Stand by. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Nice job, guys.